गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द डिजीजेज दैट आर कॉज्ड बाय द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. सो देयर आर सम डिजीजेज दैट आर कॉज्ड इन द एनिमल्स लाइक काउ, बफेलो. दे आर एनकाउंटर्ड विद दिस फुट एंड माउ डिजीज. इन दिस फुट एंड माउ डिजीज स्वेलिंग ओकर इन देयर फुट एंड माउथ एंड दे आर नॉट एबल टू ईट देयर फूड. So mainly it is due to this virus concept is there. Due to virus, this foot and mouth disease occur in the cattles. And next concept is of plants. In plants, a citrus canker, it attack on various plants and it is caused by a bacteria. And it is transmitted by the mode of air. The name of disease is citrus canker. That is caused by bacteria and it is caused in, it mainly take place in plants. The mode of transmission is air. Next category of microorganism is food spoiling microorganisms. Mainly they spoil our food and main those microorganisms which spoil our food are fungus and bacteria. You should know first this thing concept in mind. Fungus and bacteria are mainly responsible for the spoiling of food. They mainly grow in, more they grow in warm temperature, moisture environment. Where there will be a moisture environment, na, both bacteria and fungi, they will grow at a faster speed. And in warm temperature also, they will grow at a faster speed. And when they spoil the food, na, they produce some toxic substances over the food and that food is not fit for the eating purposes. And if some person eat that food, na, he may suffer from food poisoning. What fungus and bacteria do when they reside on the food, they produce some harmful toxic substances, zaharile padarth, that will cause the food poisoning. How you will come to know your food stop? That means your food is attacked by these microorganisms. Its taste will become sour. Its taste changes. Okay. A cotton-like growth will appear on the surface of food, like due to fungus. The color of food will change. Its taste will become sour, like milk, and there is gas formation in the food. So if all of these indications are taking place, now that is sure your food is attacked by the microorganism. So there is a method whose name is food preservation. So food preservation is a process in which food is treated so that it can be in which food is protected from the attack of microorganisms. Food preservation include all the methods in which food is protected from the attack of microorganisms. So mainly food is protected from the attack of microorganisms. So this is food preservation, a method, in which food is protected. Okay, how you can protect the food? You can practice the method of boiling. When you boil a milk, na, mainly harmful microorganisms in the milk, present in the milk, they are killed. And your food and your milk will be preserved. Boiling kills the harmful microorganisms, so food is preserved. Second method is dehydration. Dehydration means removal of water from the food. If water is removed, na, from the food, the growth of microorganisms will be very slow. Third concept is canning. You can store the food in cans, like jams are stored in cans. No air is able to make contact with the food. If air will not make a contact with the food, now the microorganisms will not find easy to attack the food. Fourth concept is place the food in refrigerators. If the temperature is low, now microorganisms will not be able to attack the food. In refrigerators, food is placed at lower temperature, and at lower temperature the attack of microorganism is not great. Fifth one is now these days companies are using preservatives in food materials to prevent the attack of microorganisms. A main preservative which is mainly used is a sodium benzoate. This sodium benzoate is a preservative that is mainly used in ketchups. And the sixth concept is using salt. We are using oil, salt in pickles to prevent it from the attack of fungus. And seventh main method is pasteurization. In pasteurization, what is being done? First, milk is heated to a high temperature and then cooled. Then at the same time it is cooled, first it is heated to a high temperature, then cooled and stored at a lower temperature than 10 degrees Celsius. So this is also a method of preserving the milk. A question can come, what is pasteurization? Heating at high temperature and then cooling and storing at low temperature below 10 degrees Celsius. So three things are there: heating, cooling and storing at lower than 10 degrees Celsius. That is pasteurization. Mainly, the plants, they need nitrogen for the production of proteins, protein production. But plants cannot absorb the nitrogen directly from the atmosphere. They can't do that. So there are some leguminous crops like moong dal, peas. Moong dal is there and peas is there. In the root, these structures are known as root nodules. In the root nodules of the leguminous crops, a bacteria whose name is rhizobium, he lives. He will absorb the nitrogen from the air and convert it into nitrite and nitrate. This is a soluble form of a nitrogen. They can be dissolved in water. Soluble form. This soluble form is absorbed by the roots of a plant, other plants, okay, for the production of proteins, and the growth of this plant will take place. It will have leaves and food also. The leaves, it would be eaten by the herbivores. That means nitrogen compounds will get transferred into the body of herbivores. These herbivores are eaten by carnivores. The nitrogen compounds are transferred into the body of carnivores. When these carnivores die, their bodies are acted up by microorganisms. Okay, their bodies are acted upon by microorganisms. When their bodies are acted upon by microorganisms, they will convert the nitrogen compounds present in the dead bodies of carnivores again into nitrites and nitrites, which is again absorbed by the plants. So this is a kind of cycle which is taking place in the nature. So this cycle is known as the nitrogen cycle. So this you have to explain all as a nitrogen cycle. First you have to tell the story of this rhizobium bacteria. Then you have to discuss the concepts of. After the soluble compounds of nitrogen has been gained by the plants, from plants it goes to herbivores, carnivores. Their bodies are acted upon by microorganism. Again, some chemical reactions will take place due to the action of microorganism, and they will convert the compounds of nitrogen present in the dead body of microorganisms again into nitrite and nitrate, which is again absorbed by the plants. This process continues. So this is the nitrogen cycle. So there is another chapter name is Sex, Combustion and Flame. So we will discuss some basic concepts of this chapter, combustion and flame. So what is this in this combustion? First of all, you should know what is the meaning of this combustion. The meaning of combustion is mainly when a fuel burns in the presence of air, oxygen. Suppose wood is burning in the presence of oxygen, you can say the combustion is taking place. Burning of fuel in the presence of oxygen, that is combustion. For a combustion, fuel must be there, oxygen must be there, and a proper temperature should be there. Like carbon is present in wood. When it burns in the presence of oxygen, then carbon dioxide gas is released. Okay. Mainly the substance which is burning, it is known as fuel. Mainly you know that. Okay. Same way I have told you, wood is burning in the presence of oxygen, you can say combustion is taking place. Okay. Mainly there is a concept. There are two things. Suppose a fuel is burning and there is some volatile substance present in the fuel. What is this volatile substance? Volatile substance is a substance which can change into vapor state. Suppose a fuel is there. Suppose a petrol is there. You know it is a volatile substance. It can change into vapor form. When the petrol will burn, there will be a flame. You have seen the flame. So if a fuel is having volatile substance, it will form a flame. If a fuel is not having volatile substance, it would not form any kind of flame. Okay, you must remember these two things. Which kind of fuels will form the flame and which kind of fuels will not form the flame. The fuel that burns in the presence of oxygen, you can say it is a combustible substance. Like what is a combustible substance? Petrol, diesel, they are all combustible substances. And the substances which do not burn in the presence of oxygen, they are non-combustible substances. Iron is a non-combustible, water, sand, they are all non-combustible substances. And third concept you should know, what are combustible substances and what are non-combustible substances. And last concept is, you should know the fuel should be there for the combustion. Oxygen should be there. So these are the two requirements. Presence of fuel, presence of oxygen. Every fuel require a minimum temperature to catch the fire. Wood requires more amount of temperature to catch the fire. And petrol require less amount of temperature to catch the fire. And that temperature is known as igneous temperature. Igneous temperature is the minimum temperature that is required by a fuel to catch the fire. So there should be three things. Fuel should be there, oxygen should be there, and presence of igneous temperature should be there. So suppose if a dung cake is there, it is moist, it can't burn fast. But if it's dry, it can burn fast. So igneous temperature should be there. So conditions of combustion. A question can come in your exam. What are the conditions of combustion? You can say fuel should be there, oxygen should be there, igneous temperature should be there. Without oxygen, fuel cannot burn or combustion cannot take place. You have to prove with an activity. The oxygen is required for the combustion. Take a burning candle. Take a table. Place a burning candle on it. Invert a glass over the candle. After some time, the candle switch off और कैंडल विल स्टॉप बर्निंग. द सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन गेट्स कटेड डाउन, दैट्स वाई द कैंडल स्टॉप्ड बर्निंग. सो दिस प्रूव्स ऑक्सीजन इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर कंबस्शन. सो यू कैन एक्सप्लेन दिस एक्टिविटी टू प्रूव ऑक्सीजन इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर कंबस्शन. सो द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज इग्निशियस टेम्परेचर. I've told you earlier also, igneous temperature is the minimum temperature at which fuel start burning. And suppose, remember this point, the igneous temperature of petrol is 246 degrees Celsius. 246 degrees Celsius. If you provide 246 degrees Celsius to a petrol, it will start burning. Okay. Just, we will say, we just take a polythene bag. Polythene bag in the sunlight, okay, place it for half an hour, it will not burn. Now place a convex lens then a polythene paper on the ground. The sun rays will get collected at one point on the polythene, it will start burning. Total heat of the sun will get collected at one point on the polythene, and this point has, and the igneous temperature of this polythene bag at this point has reached, it will start burning. When it start burning, the other portion of the polythene paper will get the desired temperature due to the ongoing heat. So there is no need every time to provide the igneous temperature. The fire that have started, it would serve the igneous temperature condition for the other part of the polythene bag. So this is the concept. So you can give activity. We take a polythene bag, place it on a ground half an hour, not burning. Place a convex lens over the polythene bag. The sun rays collected at one point, polythene bag start burning. All the ray of sun get collected at one point, igneous temperature of that point get reached, and polythene bag start burning. So this is the game. Just take a paper, newspaper, make it or fold it in the shape of a cup and fill some water in the cup. Now place this cup over the burning candle. You will see paper will not caught the fire. Why? The heat that is supplied by this candle will get transferred to the water for heating purposes. The paper will not get its igneous temperature, so it will not caught the fire. So science says different substances like petrol and wood, they have different igneous temperature. If the igneous temperature is very low, the fuel would catch fire at a very fast speed. And you can say it is an inflammable substance. Inflammable substances have low igneous temperature and catch fire very easily. Very easy, like petrol. You have seen on the tankers of petrol, there is written inflammable substance. So this is a inflammable substance. So with this, your lecture is over for today. Hope you enjoyed today's lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.